Dear students, we now move on to the next thing. After learning the steps for writing a balanced chemical equation, we will now see what is the information that is conveyed by a chemical equation. So what information does a chemical equation give us? So let's see what is the information. So again I use the same chemical equation. So the first thing what a chemical equation tells us is that it tells us the reactants and products which are involved in that chemical reaction. So who are my reactants and what are my products? So my reactants here are magnesium and oxygen, and my product is magnesium oxide, MgO. Secondly, it tells us the symbols and formulae of the reactants and products. As you can see here, the symbol of magnesium is Mg, because Mg is a metal, so it will have a symbol, whereas oxygen O2 is a formula. Yeah, because the oxygen ka symbol is O and formula is O2. Symbol is different and formula is different. And it also tells us the formula of the product also. The other product is magnesium oxide, that is MgO. So it also tells you the symbols and formulae of the reactants and products. It gives you that information. Third information that it gives you is the physical states, the reactants and products. As you can see in this equation here on the top, your magnesium is in the solid state, oxygen is in the gaseous state, and magnesium oxide is in the solid state. Fourthly, tells you the conditions like heat, that is temperature, pressure, catalyst, etc., which are needed for bringing about the reaction, for making the reaction to happen. As in this case, you all know, we all have learned that we need to heat the magnesium ribbon, or we need to burn the magnesium ribbon. So burning. So that is very. So we have mentioned on the arrow here the condition, that is heat. That you need to heat it, or what you call, you need to burn the magnesium ribbon. What else is it? What else does the chemical equation tell us? It tells us the relative numbers of molecules of reactants and products. Relative, okay? So comparative sort of, you can say. So what, as you can see here, it tells me that two atoms of magnesium and one, see on the oxygen, the left hand side of oxygen, there is no number. So what is the number there? You have to understand it, the number is one. So two atoms of magnesium and one atom and one molecule of oxygen gives you two molecules of magnesium oxide. So it tells you the relative numbers. So when you take, so generally two atoms of magnesium and one molecule of oxygen will always give you two molecules of magnesium oxide. And the last piece of information which equation gives you is the relative masses of reactants and products. The relative masses. So if you can see here, I have calculated for you. Let's see this thing. As you can see here, magnesium. What is the mass of magnesium here? We are using 2 Mg. So 2 Mg means two atoms of magnesium. So one atom of, what is the atomic mass of magnesium? 24. So 2 Mg means 2 × 24, 48 grams. Then next thing, oxygen. Oxygen ka atomic mass is 16. But it is O2, that means there is 2 oxygen. So I have to write 2 × 16. 1O is 16, so 2O is 2 × 16, 32 grams. And MgO. Okay, MgO. Mg is 24 and O is 16. We all know the atomic mass we learned last year. So 24 plus 16 becomes 40. Now it is 2 MgO, so becomes 2 × 40, that is 80 grams. So I hope you got how to find, how it tells you the masses of the reactants and the what? Products. Now as you can see here, boys, let me bring it to your notice that we use 48 grams of magnesium and we used 32 grams of oxygen. So 48 plus 32 becomes how much, boys? 80. And on the right hand side, MgO, 2 MgO was how many grams? 80 grams. So you saw, input is equal to output. You use 80 grams of reactants and you got 80 grams of products. So both the sides are balanced. The last year, if you remember, we learned the law of conservation of mass during a reaction. You know, we saw in the chemical reaction, the total mass of the reactants, total masses of the reactants is always equal to total mass of the products. So we put in 80 grams of reactants, that is 48 grams of magnesium and 32 grams of oxygen. So 48 to 32, 80, and we got 80 grams of magnesium oxide, that is 2 into 40, 80 grams of magnesium oxide. We now move on to the next part, that is the classification of chemical reactions. Now, there are various ways of classifying chemical reactions. In this chapter, you learn three different ways of classifying chemical reactions. Like, for example, if I were to give you an example, there are various ways in which you can classify animals. Yeah, first way of classifying animals, I can classify them as herbivorous, those who eat plants, carnivorous, those who eat animals, other animals, and omnivorous, those animals who eat plants as well as other animals. So I can classify herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous. What is the other way of classifying animals? I can classify as diurnal and nocturnal. Diurnal matlab those animals who are active during the daytime. That's why the word diurnal, D for diurnal, D for daytime. And N for, and we can also classify animals as nocturnal animals. That is, those animals who are active during the night time. N for nocturnal, N for night time. So that is the second way, diurnal and nocturnal. We can classify animals as diurnal and nocturnal. Who are the diurnal animals? All the giraffe and all the giraffe, tigers and all lions, they are active during daytime. Who are the nocturnal animals? Like, for example, cockroaches and rats who come out only during the night time. Owl, they are all active during the night time. Bats and all. The third way in which you can classify animals is, let's say you can classify is that domestic and wild animals. Domestic like goat, cows, buffaloes, and wild animals are like tigers, hyenas, cheetahs. They are all wild animals. So you can see the same animals you could classify in three different ways. No, herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous. One way. Other way was diurnal and nocturnal. Second way of classifying, and third way of classifying was, what is that? Domestic and wild. So also we have got three, there are three ways in which you can classify chemical reaction. Let's see these three ways. So there are three different ways of classifying chemical reaction. So let's see the firstly, they can be classified as follows. That is combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, and double displacement reaction. The second way of classifying chemical reaction is oxidation, reduction, and redox reaction. And the third and the last way of classifying chemical reaction, which you'll be learning this year, is exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction. And we'll be learning this in detail, okay, in the later slides.